What's up, guys? Seth the J Fox here. Today, I am giving you guys a day in the life of a Towson University EMF major. My focus is film. I was just showing you guys around the whisper room, audio lab area, something. I'm in a studio right now. Going to work on a song just for a little bit, but I want to show you guys the upstairs building. We're actually in what's called the Media Center. It's a small building just kind of to the right of the library, Albert Cook Library. But I'm going to show you guys a brief walk around. There's a lot of rooms that I can't necessarily get into just because, like, I'm not taking specific courses, which I do want to talk a little bit more about, because with this whisper room situation, as an EMF major, you're required to take Audio 1, which I'm taking this semester, is my sophomore year, but you're required to take Audio 1. But if you're not enrolled in an audio class,
you're done.
You're not going to be able to take, or you're not going to be able to use any of these rooms. And in addition to that, which is a little jiggy, but that's fine. If you're not enrolled in any video classes, even if you're an EMF major, if you're not enrolled in any video classes, you can't get a camera. Which we have the camera cage. I don't know if I'm able to show you guys inside of that. I would love to. I might, when I go pick up my card, because you have to leave your ID when you're in one of these lovely rooms. But when I go to pick up my card, I'll try to just like get a little bit of footage, but there's the camera cage where you get nice, cool camera equipment. I didn't get any of this stuff. Any of this stuff from the camera cage. I got it from the library, but this is the camera I'm using, Canon 90D. And this microphone. Neat stuff. But anyway, I'm going to show you guys the production lab where they have a bunch of Macs for you to use and edit, and they have like some color grading equipment, all a bunch of cool stuff. I'm gonna show you guys the actual Media Center building where, as an EMF major, you'll be taking your classes, and you know, if you have access to that TV studio, then you'll be in there. And then one more thing. This was the third thing, was the audio labs, which is one of my favorite things. And it also says here, if you can see it, absolutely no food or drink inside the whisper room. Violators will be asked to leave and all future reservations will be canceled. But you'll be done. You'll be done. So let's not cancel our careers this early, right? No eating in the labs. All right, so I'm going to play with some stuff for a little bit just so you guys can, like, get a feel for the room. And then we'll move on to some other things. I have 2 hours in here, so I'm not going to, you know, be in here the whole time. But that is a microphone. And if your track in EMF at Towson University is audio, oh, and they've got speakers, JBL and that. If your focus is audio, then this should be pretty impressive for you. They've got mics, they've treated the rooms, and the software they use is Pro Tools on all of these doohickeys. Now, I've used almost every, I haven't used, what's it called? Ableton. I haven't used Ableton, but I've used GarageBand, Logic, Presonus, FL Studios, blah, blah, blah. Not Pro Tools, but I guess this is why the class I'm taking is pretty cool, because they teach Pro Tools. So I'm going to boot it up, kind of show you at least what it looks like to work in here. So you can imagine and get excited if you're coming to Towson. I'm going to talk about, you know, all of my experience. I've only been here before my freshman year and sophomore year, but I wanted to do this before I potentially transfer, which we'll talk about in another video. But yeah, let's look at some stuff.
Won't you ride with me? Won't you ride with me? Won't you ride with me? Yeah. Ride with me.
That's the beat I made, though. I made this last night. It was fun. I did it in 30 minutes. And that was awesome to do, but here's how, I'll play it again. Okay, so this is one of the studios as well, for the audio people. I've recorded some videos in here with Towson's radio station, some like performance videos, shot, edited, awesome. But yeah, this is one of these rooms. I don't know exactly how you're able to get access to this one. I think I have access to it because I'm in Audio 1. So if you're just, like I said, if you're enrolled in any audio classes, then you get access. But this is the biggest studio room. It'd be so cool to, like, I don't know if we have this, and I don't think we do, but, like, for film majors to have access to, like, just a set kind of room. Like, a room like this, blank space, and we can just go in and, like, shoot our films in there and make sets and all of this stuff. I feel like we should have that. I know we have the TV studio, and I know in the library there's, like, but that's a separate branch or department, but it's the Student Computing Center. There's a space where you can rent out the cameras. Like, I got this Zoom, and I got the camera I'm shooting on now from there. But you can rent out equipment and rent out a space to shoot. But, like, this room is, like, awesome. Like, we've shot several videos and stuff in here in which they, you know, kind of were saying, like, we don't want to let you guys shoot anymore. But that's, you know, it's a whole other thing. And that's the, where the actual mixer. Oh, that's why it was locked. Because they, I guess, don't have the mixer in there at the moment. They're getting a new one, perhaps, or something happened to the old one. Who knows? But we are going to go, as I've said, to tour the rest of the film department. Towson University's film department. But yeah. Alright, so boom. This is Towson University's production lab. It's pretty neat. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. They have a bunch of the Mac Studio M2s, which is very cool. So it's powerful computers. And they have software for video editing, music production. Like, they've got Pro Tools, Premiere Pro, Adobe After Effects, all of that goodness. So if you're like me and you're coming to Towson without a computer, Towson has a bunch of them in the production lab and in the library for you to use. It's pretty tight. It's pretty tight. Now I'm going to show you what their standard T7i camera kit looks like, which film students enrolled in a video production class. I heavily emphasize this because if you're not enrolled in video production classes, you cannot rent, which I found out recently when I tried to book, and I was like, where are the camera options? But because I wasn't enrolled in a class, they revoked my access. I'm like, yo, I'm an EMF student. What's going on here? What's going on? But anyway, if you're enrolled in a video production class, you can book the equipment online and then come to the production lab to pick it up. But let's see what it comes with.
All right, so boom, you get this really cool black techie looking bag, which is fun. And some of these kits come with like a slate, which this one doesn't. I think the ADD does, but you got an XLR cable. This is one of them, the smaller one. You come with it comes with like two or three. You got the windscreen, the protection mic and stuff. It's good stuff. Mixer to set up your microphones. What else we got? Oh yeah, this one's cool because this is your shotgun mic. And this is crucial for your filmmaking journey because this is the mic that everybody uses. Like, you see the guy holding the boom pole. What he's holding through the boom pole is a shotgun mic. The more you know. And then with this, you have a lav mic, which is the are those, like, interview mics that you clip onto somebody's shirt and, you know, record like that. Like, if you're on Oprah or something, you do that. And this is what you would connect your shotgun to and record. It's an audio recorder. And it also picks up audio itself. But with this kit, it will not come with batteries, except for this one, which is for your camera. But for the audio recorder, you need your own battery. And that's our shotgun mount, or shock mount. And the thing in my left hand was a top handle. And then we got some Q-tips to clean your lens. I didn't show the camera because that's actually the camera that I'm filming with. But that's the long XLR cable. So if you want to hook it up to, say you want to hook up your shotgun directly to the camera, you would use the really, really long shotgun mic, you know, if the camera's far away and yada, yada. But there's smarter ways to do it, which hopefully you'll learn if you join the program or if you, you know, just, hey, YouTube, whatever. But hope you guys enjoyed this portion. Let's get on to the next stage. So, that was the media center, and this is Dr. Julius Chapman's quadrangle. I hope the foot, I didn't get to look at the footage while I was shooting it, but that was the media center. I showed you guys upstairs, downstairs, and some of the audio labs. I'm also show you guys that building, which you can't see, but it's over there. And that's supposed to be the new, like, media center. So if you're a film major, audio major, and anything related to that realm, you'll be in that gargantuan building. But this is where I shot several class projects. Like, if you take a class here and, like, film one, for example, they'll typically have you come out with the equipment and just shoot out here, play with it, get a feel for it. At least that's what my teacher did. But it's nice. It's very cold. Don't be deceived by the sun. It's very cold at the moment, so I should hurry up and get my jacket on. But I at least wanted to show you guys this side. So this media center here, library right there, and I'll do like a little walkthrough so you guys can get a gist of for the lay of the land. But yeah, hope you guys are enjoying this far. We're almost finished, almost to the end. But Towson's cool. Towson is cool. If you guys have any more questions about, like, my experience here, let me make sure this is recording. My experience here, we can talk about it. I might do a video, like, actually discussing some of my experiences with classes, professors, a little bit about, like, my transferring situation, like, why I'm transferring. It's nothing ambiguous. But yeah, pros, some cons, help you decide. Let's move on to the next location.
Desire for beat.
So, behind me is Smith Hall. That's the new building. This is not turning on, by the way, so I just gotta rely on the camera's audio. But, yeah. I guess this concludes our tour of Towson University's film department. It's as best as I could. I couldn't get into the camera cage to record, and I couldn't get into the TV studio just because I don't know how you get access to the TV studio. I think you might need a professor there with you or something like that. But I showed you the cool parts that I could show you. The rest, I guess you'll have to see as you're deciding if you want to come to Towson. Like I said, I'll talk more in depth, and if you guys want like a bigger tour of the campus, it's a pretty big campus. I've heard that University of Maryland is like 45 times bigger than, not 45, but it's a little bigger. But yeah, it's pretty big. We got dining halls over there, Union. This is the psychology building that I'm sitting in front of. But it's nice. It's cool. And like I said, I can talk more in depth in another video. But this is just kind of like, if you're like, oh, what is the film department like? Or I'm coming in to Towson as an EMF major. I don't know what to expect at all, other than like videos from 10 years ago. Well, hopefully this helps. You've seen the production lab. You've seen the whisper rooms, which is a big, that's like, not the best at the angle, but that's like a really big element that I think is cool. I'm not even a production major, like an audio production major, but that one's cool. The production line. Let me keep Towson in the background. And there's people working on that building as we speak. But yeah, Towson's cool. I think as a freshman, even sophomore, you'll enjoy it when you come. Don't be worried too much about prior experience. You're here to learn and have fun. And I'd say for my freshman year and sophomore year, I've had fun playing with the equipment, experiencing new things. Just because I'm thinking about transferring doesn't mean, or just because I am transferring, doesn't mean that there's something wrong with Towson. It's just like everybody's growth is different. And I feel that here I've grown as much as I needed to and have maybe outgrown it. And you might feel the same, or you might be like, yo, this is the best college ever. And I would say, hey, yeah, it's fine. Yeah, that's awesome. I'm glad you're enjoying it. But I want to explore and see what else the world has to offer, you know. But don't be afraid. It'll be a different experience, but it's a cool one. There's a little bee, hornet, something like that. I hope it's just a bee. I've seen these like videos anyway. Got the point.